רציתי להביא עוד שתי עדויות מחול של חברים של העובד שכתבו לרגל הערב הזה, ואני מבטיח לכם שהם לא ידעו מה איש יגיד, וזה די מדהים. תכף תשמעו המקבילות. פרנצ'סקה קורנלי היא פרופסור למימון בלונדון ביזנס סקול, היא כתבה כך: I often think of Ovid. I think he would have liked this, or he would have laughed at me in this case, or Ovid would have got upset about that. But most often I think of him in the middle of a seminar, when the speaker starts being a bit vague or saying something not completely consistent, and I have fun imagining what Ovid would have said or how he would have said it. I do admit this gets me quite distracted from the presentation. I know he would not have let the presenter continue until he got to the bottom of it. I really miss the clarity of his mind. ובן סורנסן, שהוא כלכלן דני, שהוא כיום ביוסטון, ואת הקטע הבא אולי כדאי לקרוא במבטא דני כבד. I am proud that I had the privilege of working with Ovid intensively for about 9 years, publishing 16 articles. I learned a lot from Ovid. Ovid was talented, but what I think I really tried to learn from Ovid was his exceptional self-discipline. He had an amazing ability to zoom in and not move on before he had a full understanding in terms of basic economic theory, but never an iota more complicated than it had to be. That made him great at the actual writing of papers. His iron will, of course, also implied that he would never rest if a deadline loomed. A colleague of mine said a few years ago that she was envious that I had worked with Ovid on so many papers. I started replying something about Ovid being a great economist, and she said, "No, I mean it must have been so much fun working with him for so long." And that gets at the other side of Ovid. He was a really warm person who always was, well, fun to work with. Ovid taught me to work in cafes and feel good while ideas banged around. Having fun and being productive, that was the joy of working with Ovid. Of course, most people also know that sometimes Ovid would blow up as a volcano if some remark just possibly could have been an oblique way of criticizing Israel. I think the volcano and his warmth and likely his economic skills all came from having a permanent hot fire burning inside him. I moved to Houston right after Ovid got the terrible news about his disease, and while we kept working, he never went on another trip to the US to present his work and work with me. I am convinced he would have liked to work in the cafes and bars in Houston, but it was never to be. I still miss him. אני אזמין את תמר שוב לנגן את האדם כעץ השדה, השיר של נתן זך שהלחין. שלום חנוך.